Alrighty then.
Hola.
Woo! What's up, y'all?
We're back.
We're back.
Again.
With more Irish fun. Woo, 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 woo. Okay, so I'm going to be real honest about the changes I made to this once you hear me out, okay?
Mm-hmm.
So this is the Drunken Leprechaun cocktail.
Okay.
Okay, full disclosure. Blah, blah, blah. Full disclosure. I literally just did the Guinness Reduction Simple Syrup. Okay.
Fancy.
Yeah, but I didn't give it ample. I did not give the ideal time to cool it down. So when you do this, what you would do is get you a can of Guinness beer,
mm-hmm.
half a cup of sugar.
Okay.
Mix that all up, boil it, reduce, and let simmer for a few minutes and let completely cool down. I had to do a whole ice bath situation because time was of the essence.
Gotta do what you gotta do.
The other thing, I kind of forgot to do the honey simple syrup, child.
Okay.
So we're using agave.
Ain't no wrong with that.
And that's fine. So it's probably going to be slightly different in taste, but I think we will still get the gist of what this is supposed to taste like.
Yeah.
So full disclosure. Okay. When we draft this up, we'll draft it up with the appropriate ingredients.
Yeah.
And not like the
what we did.
We had what we had. Version. Okay. So
mm-hmm.
we have our shakers with ice. So let's go ahead and get started. I just would like to start with the spirit. Let's start with our Irish whiskey. Now, this recipe calls for Jameson, which is like probably the most well-known Irish whiskey out there. But Kilbrand been doing it the same, okay?
It's been going fine. It's always been in my cabinet, okay?
So that's what we finna use. And it's 3 ounces of this guy. So this
three.
Is a, I said what I said.
I'm not even mad at it. See, if it was vodka, then we have a different story.
Yeah, I know
but
you
this is
your feelings. So that's uno.
Dos.
And tres.
Hola. It's me, Dora.
Hey, yo.
Do you want to know how many drinks I can have?
Jump in, follow us. You can leave the wedding. Hey, hey. She's Dora. She's Dora.
Oh, my gosh. Okay. Oh, yeah, she's still. I forgot. She's still going.
You said three, right?
Three.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Yep.
Yeah, I'm just making sure.
Oh, yeah, no, you was right. You was right, girl.
Mm-hmm.
Then we're going to do 1 ounce of the Guinness Reduction Syrup that I hurriedly prepared.
1 ounce. Ooh, this might be good.
Okay. And provide that there. Okay.
Okay.
This calls for one and... Sorry. This calls for 1.5 ounces of our honey simple syrup, but we're using agave. So I'm gonna finish this off.
You said it was one?
1.5 ounces.
A lot of syrup. Oh, a lot of agave.
Okay, that's the end of that.
That's done.
It served its purpose.
Mm-hmm. Got it. No.
Had to be a little ghetto there. That's all right. Okay, so that's one. Now I gotta do a half. This is a lot.
Yeah.
It probably means it's gonna be sweet.
But I mean, you added an extra ounce typical than your normal basic average drink. So.
Roll.
Still a lot of sugar.
This is true. And then we're gonna do 1 ounce of fresh squeezed lemon juice. Again, Safeway provided, I purchased. Holler at me, okay?
Whatever you got.
There you go.
And
1 ounce of that.
1 ounce.
I know.
Okay.
Okay, so now we can shake.
Okay. I
actually think this is gonna be quite good.
I agree. Make sure that agave get in there.
Mm-hmm. Okay. We have our coupe glasses. Well, I feel like I'm gonna have extras. Like, I don't think I can. Oh, yeah. I have
We have reserves.
I have reserves. I don't want it to get iced down. You have reserves too?
Yeah.
All right, hold on.
I got me a jar.
Don't mind us. We wasn't ready.
No.
For
it. No. She wasn't ready.
We weren't ready for the gift that kept giving.
And I'm back.
She has returned. Ooh. And then I'm gonna rip the stem off of this guy. But garnish with some fresh mint. Ooh. I guess that's what makes it leprechaun-y because it's the green.
Mm. So
that's all right.
I'm gonna take the stem off though.
Yeah, I had to take the stem off.
Look, I got a four-leaf clover.
Oh my God, it's lucky.
So Lucky Charms, they're magically delicious.
Yes, I'm gonna do it.
All right.
Okay, so let's try this.
Oh, look at it all fancy.
Yeah, look at it. Okay.
Oh my God.
You make me wanna say oh my gosh.
Oh my gosh.
I'm happy. That's tasty. Hey, 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 hey.
We get it fucked up tonight.
Okay. Anyway.
Oh, this is good. In the Guinness.
Hey.
It's like a little hint of it in the back.
Imagine if that had actually like cooled off. I'ma use it. I'ma use that again.
Yeah.
I think I can probably, it'll probably last me for at least 3 weeks.
But this, all of it.
Okay, so you go first. Like, tell us what you're thinking.
I like this. You gotta be careful with this. Not only you got the Guinness, you got the whiskey. And all of it works. And you know what's crazy about it is we did an alternative. So imagine.
The honey syrup. If you did the honey simple syrup.
What else? Did we do any other alternative? That was just it?
No, it wasn't an alternative. I just rushed the Guinness.
Oh, okay. So it all works. So, I mean, I can only imagine what the honey probably be a little bit more potent, maybe. Agave's a little bit more subtle.
Agave's a little more subtle. And keep in mind, it's not straight honey, so it's honey simple syrup. So it would still have the consistency of an agave, because again, it will have the consistency of a simple syrup.
Yeah.
But it will probably just have a slightly different note to it.
Okay.
Continue.
Sorry. Okay, no worries. But I do like this, and I will definitely give this a flat, solid 10. If I could give it longer, I mean more, I would, but a 10 is good for me.
Yes.
Your turn, babe.
Okay, good. So I'll just start off the bat with what we care about is absolutely a 10. This is really good. The reason that this could get you messed up is because it is sweet enough to make you forget that there are 3 ounces of Irish whiskey.
But you know what, Irish whiskey though, it's not your typical.
It's not as grating as American whiskey. So that is very true. I mean, again, depending on the brand. So let's also specify that. But I still agree. It's not as
we
harsh.
Might have to make another batch.
Baby, I'm gonna drink this in full. I mean, I'll put my reserves away, but I'm gonna drink this. Okay. This is cute. I mean, I don't really know too many people necessarily that are throwing St. Patty's Day themed jigs, but if you are, you need to put the Drunken Leprechaun cocktail on your list because it's super unconventional in terms of the types of cocktails along the themes that we think of.
Yeah.
I mean, we think of Irish Car Bomb, did it. Just straight up Jameson shots.
Mm-hmm.
I don't, Guinness beer. So this is thinking outside of the box. It's using the Guinness beer, but it is but you do a little cooking, okay, not really. Yeah, you just, no. I support this fully. This is delicious.
I'm gonna have to probably go to the bar and ask for, hey, give me the Drunken Leprechaun.
See, they would be lost, because you know what? They would not probably have a Guinness Reduction sauce on tap. They might have the honey, but you know what? If you go to, like, DC has a lot of these really cool, like, if you go to a speakeasy, or if you go some one of those, like, bars that are very focused on the cocktail experience, you probably could order that there.
Yeah.
But if you just go into your regular sports bar, baby, they're going to look at you crazy.
Yeah, because that Guinness part, yeah, they're not going to...
They will pour some Guinness beer in your drink, and you'll be short. You'll be upset. Because
the
Guinness Reduction is the beer plus sugar added, right? It's almost like you're making a simple syrup.
Right.
So,
this is
good. This is supposed to be a mini segment. This is an episode, child.
Damn. That's good. Woo! You taste it, but you don't taste it.
And I taste the Guinness. It's balanced. It is pleasant. It is not like...
Man, can you put that like on food maybe or something? Just doing something.
You know what? You could probably do a glaze. Probably do a glaze.
Once it settles a little bit more.
Yep.
Child, Jack Daniels, good. Irish is about to come in.
If you can do a Jack Daniels glaze, because people do, then
Damn,
do a Guinness. Child, listen, I know you don't want to sit here and watch us drink this while saying it's delicious. So we'll just do our normal. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. I know we say this every week, but actually you should try this because it's out of the box and it's a good out of the box. It's not like I picked the onion. Yeah. So
if I knew how to line dance, I'd be over here. Oh Lord, I'm getting sharper.
Hey, I mean, if anything, I'm gonna learn to line dance because Beyonce out here about to put out a whole country item. I'm gonna have to use, who remembers in elementary school when we had to do them line dances? Did y'all have to do that? Yeah, we actually had to do line dance in your school back in the day.
I'm trying to take care of a kid. I've been in a trench, you can't reach. That's my dog show.
We did everything from skating to stilts to line dancing. It was the 90s was an interesting time.
I didn't get to fifth grade until 2001, so there's that.
Anyway, okay, so we'll be back because we're gonna enjoy the rest of this. Yep. We'll see y'all later. Bye.